Hello students, I am Ishan Trivedi. Welcome you in this video lecture series. Today I am going to discuss about the Detroit method, which is part of growth factor method of tree distribution analysis. So in this session I am going to cover the Detroit method explanation with its example. So let us first understand what is Detroit method. In this method, this was first adopted in the Detroit metropolitan area, that is in USA, for the tree distribution study in 1956. The model assumes that the future trees from zone I to zone J are proportional to the growth factor of zone Fi, or you can say I, and multiply by the growth factor of zone J, that is Fj, and divided by an average growth of factor for the entire area. Here you can see the equation, which is representative equation of Detroit method. That is capital Tij is equal to small Tij into Fi into Fj upon F. So what it tells you, that the growth factor of zone I, that is Fi, into growth factor of J, that is of Fj, upon the average growth factor of entire matrix or of entire study area that we are going to compute, and it is in the form of capital F. So here the capital Tij denotes the futuristic trips from zone I to zone J. Then small Tij denotes the present trips from zone I, that is origin, to zone J, that is destination, or you can say in the form of trip production to trip attraction. Then capital Fi is the growth factor of zone I. Then Fj, capital Fj, denotes the growth factor of zone J. Capital F denotes the growth factor of entire area. So by equation you can easily say that this method combines the uniform growth factor method and the average growth factor method. This method uses the separate growth factor for the zones and also for the overall growth factor for the entire area. So I'm going to find out two growth factor for the zone individually and the growth factor of entire area, and therefore there are more rational and better approach for finding the results. So let us have the example and we will study this method in detail. So let us have a problem statement. Here you can see the trip distribution of present trips among the zone ABC are given in the OD matrix. The future trips are generated and denoted as a capital TI are also given in the last column, as you can see in the here. Distribute the future trips among the zone using the Detroit method. So here we have the origin. In column we have the destination. All those column value are the destination and the horizontal values are origin value. Here whatever the futuristic trip is been given to you, it is of summation, or you can say it is representative value of this row. Similarly, these values also imply at all those attractions, because if we have the futuristic production, then similar in nature we have this futuristic attraction. So I'll just put these value, as we have the vertical value, I'll just put it horizontal as well. So first we will understand the equation. What we have the value, we have the capital Ti is equal to small Ti into Fi into Fj upon F. O stands for origin, D stands for destination. Here we have the origin value, we have here destination value. Small Tij represent the present trips, or you can say present trips which are generated among the interzonal activity. Hence capital Fi, it is the growth factor of zone I, which is also calculated by capital Pi upon small Pi. Fj, it is the growth factor of zone J, capital Aj upon small Aj. Capital F, that is the growth factor of entire study area of all the zone, and that is of any one side, we have the capital P I upon small p, or you can say capital T I j upon small t I j, which are the representative value of futuristic and the present traits respectively. So let us have a solution of this problem statement, and we will going to calculate based on the Detroit method equation. In our first iteration, we have the equation, and I'll just plot all the given data here, that is origin and destination of ABC zone, and I'll plot the interzonal activity. Now I'll calculate the small pi value. I already told how to calculate this pi value. It is just a summation of all those horizontal interzonal activity between capital A to this A, capital A to B, capital A to C value. Here we have the summation of all those interzonal activity in the form of present trip production. Similarly, we have the small aj value, that is the attraction of all those vertical calculation we are going to make. I have already told you this how to calculate. Now we have the value of total trip generated at present condition, at the present trips. These are the 1300, and I'll just make the summation of all those production and the attraction. It is similar, that is 1300. Now we have the capital PI value. It is given in the data. Similarly, we have the capital AG value. As I told you, that whatever the trips are going to generated in future are, or you can say produce, are going to attracted, or and we have the destination for the same. So here we have the capital PI and capital AJ value. Now what I need to find out, I need to find out the summation of all those trip or futuristic trip generation, that is 4740. I just make the summation of all those values. Similarly, these are same in nature. Now similarly, I'll find out the factor for individual row. These we have done in average growth factor method. Here I make the find out the growth factor of these values: 360 divided by 360, 1260 divided by 420, 3120 divided by 520, and we have the growth factor. Similarly, for the future attraction, and we have the growth factor similar, that is 1, 3 and 6 respectively for zone A, B and C. Clear? Now we need to calculate the entire area growth factor, that is growth factor which denotes the F, capital F value, and for that I'll just make it simple, that is F is equal to capital PI upon small pi, or you can say capital TIJ upon small TIJ, and that is summation of all those futuristic trips upon summation of all those present trips, and that is 4740 upon 1300. Here I am going to take the entire area growth factor, so I will calculate the summation of all those futuristic trips upon summation of all those present trips, and by dividing these I'll get the growth factor of entire area, and that is 3.646. Now as we have calculated for the average growth factor method, we have the calculation of interzonal activity of capital T value, and that is TAA value, that is T capital TAA is equal to small TAA into FA1 into FA1 upon F. The way we were doing in the average growth factor method, we were doing the summation. Here I am going to just multiply, the method will remain same. So what we have, TAA, that is the represent value of 60 into FAA, that is 1 into 1 divided by growth factor, that is 3.646. As I do the equation or putting such data, I'll get the answer. Here I'll put nearest values. Similarly for TAB, it is origin and destination between A and B value, and it is 100, and the factor is 1 into 3, and I'll get the answer, and I'll just put growth factor of entire area at the bottom. So here I have the answer. For AC, Again, it is 200 into 1 into 6 upon 3.646. See, you can do it for TBA. TB means this value, the relationship between the origin B and the destination A, and that value is 100 into 3 into 1 upon 3.646, and we have the answer. Similarly, for TBB value, we have the calculation and I'll just get the answer. Nearest value, that is 49 for TBC. And you can also find out for TCA, TCB and TCC. So by getting this value, I'm going to plot the matrix for first iteration. In next slide, you will find this matrix. I'll just put, instead of 60, I'll put 17. For 100, I'll put just 82. I'll replace 200 by 329. Similarly, for TBA, I'll just put 82 instead of 100 and reform the matrix. So our next matrix is for the second iteration, and for that, I will put these values which we have computed from the first iteration. So I'm just going to put this value. I'll make those summation and have the PI value and the small aj value. I'll make the summation of, again it is 4048. Now for capital PI, we have those values in the given data. Again for capital aj, we have those datas in problem statement. Now I'll find out the f value. Here we have the F value. Now we have the different growth factor, what we have computed so far in the previous iteration. Now in second iteration, I'm going to just calculate again this growth factor. This 360 divided by 428, 1260 divided by 1612, then 3120 divided by 2008, and I'll get the respective growth factor for the different zones. Similarly, I'll just compute for the FJ, that is capital AJ upon small AJ, and I'll get the similar answer. Now what I'm going to take, I'm going to take the factor for entire area, that is the summation of all those futuristic trips upon summation of all those present trips that we have computed in our first iteration. So here we have the value, that is 4740 divided by 4048, and getting the growth factor, that is 1.171. that is our new growth factor. Now I'm going to apply this growth factor and this futuristic growth factor value in our second iteration, and now our second iteration will start. So here we have the equation TAA. You know how to fill these values, small TAA, and then now we have the 17 into 0.841 into 0.841 divided by 1.171, and we have the nearest value, that is 10. For TAB, we have the 82 into 0.841 into 0.782 upon 1.171, and this is how you can do it for TAC, TBA, TBB, TBC, and at last for TCA, TCB, TCC. And ultimately, I'm going to form the matrix for our second iteration by putting these values. We have just those value I've just plotted in another matrix, and find out the small PI value, that is the summation of all those trip production. Here we have those values, and for attraction, for the destination, we have these values. Now I'll make the summation, that is nearly 4342. We have the futuristic value, it is in our data. Similarly, we have the AJ value, then summation is 4740. Now again, I'm going to find out the growth factor for horizontal values, and for vertical value, I'm going to find out the growth factor by dividing the capital AJ upon small AJ. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to just calculate the growth factor for entire area, that is 1.09. You know how to calculate this growth factor. Here the summation of all those futuristic trips that is given in our data, that is 4,740 upon the produce from the second iteration, that summation is 4,342. If I put those desirable data, I'll get the answer, that is 1.09. Here we are getting closer to the growth factor, and hence the iteration may be stopped when you find the growth factor of entire area F nearly equal to 1. And here we almost achieve the growth factor near to 1. So I am going to stop my iteration here. See, you have to calculate when the growth factor is 1. But here nearly equal to 1. So I am going to stop my iteration here. If for furthermore detailed trip generation, you can go for the third iteration. But here I am just going to achieve my growth factor near to 1, so I am going to stop my calculation here. So in exam also you have to at least show minimum 2 iteration, and those value of capital TAA, TAB, TCA, or these 9 out of 9, you have to minimum show 3 to 4 calculation. So this is how you have to write in exam. Again, I'm repeating, minimum you have to do 2 iteration, and finding the capital Tij value, you can see here, at least out of 9 entries, you have to show 3 to 4 entry for each iteration process. So total, if I'm making 2 iteration, then minimum 6 to 8 entries of this capital Tij value has to be written in the answer sheet. If you make this matrix, that is okay, but you have to have write the procedure that you are going to follow for writing this equation. So do not make this matrix directly, just show some calculation. So based on that, you will get the marks. So I'm ending this session here. I hope you have learned the Detroit method, how this calculation has been made. Thanks for watching this video.